What's up, guys? As you can see, I'm in a brand new shop. I ended up having to move for work, and so I had to uproot my whole life, pack everything up, and I'm just now getting settled into the new digs. It's kind of exciting though, because this garage is a little bit bigger than my last one, and I'm excited to just start over with a clean slate, build sort of a dream shop to continue the K100 project. As you can see, I wrapped up the whole project very carefully because I had to load it into a moving truck. This episode is going to be getting back on my feet after a long time not working on the project. This has always been just a hobby project to me. You know, I fit it around my life. There are weeks or months at a time when I just can't justify working on it. I don't have the time or the motivation. So, yeah, took a couple months off there, but I'm really excited to get back into it. And this week was my custom Cognito Moto stem and triple tree finally arrived. Okay, so today just went from a really exciting day to a super shitty day. I discovered that the diameter of the fork exceeds the diameter of the lower triple clamp. This lower portion of the fork is 54 millimeters. Inner diameter of the triple clamp is 52 millimeters. And I fucking ordered an R6. Triple clamp instead of an R1. And this is a custom part that took 6 weeks and cost $700 and it can't be returned. So the way I see it, the first option sucks. It would be order the correct triple clamp and just take a $700 loss. It's just a big bummer, really.
Guys, the day is finally here. We finally have the correct size custom triple tree and stem. Cognito Moto came through in such a big way. But we'll get to this a little later in the episode. First, I'm gonna make some quick shop updates.
And I'm excited to build out the new shop. I think priority number one, I'm gonna install a 440-pound electric hoist into the ceiling. After having picked this up with one other person and moved it, it is a bear. It's heavy. So that's gonna make moving the flying brick a lot easier, and it's gonna help me lift it up so that I can get under it when I paint it. So, now that I've finished installing the electric hoist, I'm going to test it with 200 pounds, which is a little bit less than this engine block weighs, I would assume. Oh yeah. You would have thought they would have designed it so that you could hold this up and drive screws from this direction, but in fact you have to come sort of from the top, so it's kind of annoying.
Gus likes the new shop. Isn't that right, buddy? You like the workshop? You wanna go ride motorcycles? Yay!
So one cool update I wanted to point out is since I moved garages, I took this opportunity to install new garage flooring. These are just snapped together tiles I got off of Amazon. Super easy to install and just make the place look a lot nicer.
You guys, what a huge day this is. I got the completely reworked new stem and triple tree that Cognito Moto super graciously offered to replace for me with the correct R1 triple. And so now, as you can see, the forks fit into the triple and I'm off to the races. I reached out to Cognito Moto directly and got in contact with the founder. I let him know the mistake that I had made by ordering an R6 triple instead of an R1, and he extremely graciously offered to replace the whole thing for me for no more cost than shipping. I honestly cannot thank them enough. The fact that it was clearly my mistake and it was in no way their responsibility, but they replaced it for me anyway is just amazing. If you're considering doing a K100 project of your own, or any cafe racer project for that matter, you should really consider reaching out to Cognito Moto. The product is amazing and their customer service is beyond. And this is just a huge day for me to finally see the front end coming together on the bench top. So for the time being, I've just tightened these bolts sort of hand tight because I want to get it mounted up onto the frame and then make sure the forks are level, because once these are unscrewed, the fork can slide in and out of the triple. So I want to make sure the tops of these forks are level. And Cognito Moto graciously sent an instruction leaflet as well. And if anyone has any trouble themselves, there's an installation video you can see at this link here. And it walks you through the whole process. This is sort of an exploded diagram that outlines exactly how the whole assembly comes together on the bike. And right now what we're looking at on the bench top is essentially just the lower part of the triple and the conversion stem, which is custom for the K100. And this lower triple is the one that's correctly sized for the R1 front end. So what I'm gonna do now that I have the two forks inserted and hand tightened into the lower triple is I'm gonna brace under here and hold it up through the front of the bike frame and then tighten on basically the threaded lock nuts. Another thing to note is anytime I'm working with components like this, I throw down a chamois cloth just because I'm worried about scratches before the thing gets on the bike. And you can see from the first time I put it into the frame, you get scratches on the stem, but I'm not too worried about that since this is gonna be buried inside of the frame and not visible, but I wanna be very conscious about putting any unwanted mars and scratches on the new front end. And if I was smart right now, I would take the tank off before I put this front end on just to avoid the possibility of scratching the tank, but I'm not a smart man, and so I'm just gonna throw another chamois over the top of this guy. So the way this goes, stem comes up through the frame. There are two little guides to keep the forks from knocking against the tank that are adjustable. Another shout out to Cognito Moto for a great design feature. And the first two items in the stack are these two lock nuts that thread onto the lower set of threads on the stem. The second one comes on top of that. This is all brutally apparent in the exploded drawing that's included with the Cognito Moto set. And the top of the triple comes over the top there. Last thing's this nut, just to hold that top triple in place so that I can put a little bit of weight on it. So you'll notice when I was installing the upper triple clamp, I made sure there was enough room on the top of the fork for clip-on bars. So the new exciting acquisition is these clip-ons by Driven, and they're built for an R1. And so these are gonna basically just mount to the top of the fork. You can see the paperwork here. The only call out is to ensure you have full engagement of the clip-on bar onto the fork. So you can see these clip-ons could mount one of two ways. You could come over top like this and have a lower profile bar, which I think I'm more interested in. It's a nice cafe racer look. You could also mount it on the opposite side with the bar raised up if you wanted a higher, more comfortable seating position, but I'm not interested in that. Unfortunately, if you're gonna mount it in this position with a lower bar profile, the Driven logo is gonna be upside down. I'm not too concerned about that. If I had my way, I would take off the logo entirely, but I'll cross that bridge later. Put the other one on here. I'm only gonna tighten down these screws hand tight for now because I know once I put levers and everything else on, they're gonna change position. I just wanna get a good look at the bike with them on. Quick shout out, since it's in the frame, I just got brand new 2021 KTM Duke 890R. So now we're a two KTM household. This is my fiance's Duke 390. Great little bike, super fun. I just got the delivery of the bike, so it still has the stock pipe and the ugly OEM fender. First order of business is to replace that with a fender eliminator kit. I'm almost embarrassed to be seen outside with that thing. For anyone who's interested in the 890R, initial impressions after putting 300 miles on it, holy shit, what a bike. The brakes are so insanely good. It's got dual caliper Brembos, stops on a freaking dime. The quick shifter comes stock both up and down. It auto blips for down, and at the dealer I had to pay a little fee for them to activate it. It's basically a software patch, but oh my god, totally worth it. It's changing the way I ride already, where you can downshift mid-corner. The upshifts are liquidy smooth, and everything except for going from first gear to second gear. I tend to use the clutch upshifting to second gear just because it's a little bit abrupt otherwise, but oh my god, what an incredible bike. Where I live right now in the Bay Area, there are none of these 2021 890Rs in stock, and so I actually went down to San Diego to pick this one up from GP Motorcycles, and I had it shipped to the Bay Area since I had driven down with my fiance. So I just took delivery of it again, and I took it out into the twisties, and it's an incredible bike. It's unlike anything I've ever ridden. Of course, I've never had a new bike before, so this was kind of a treat. So sorry for the diversion, but I'm just so psyched about it. It's such an amazing bike to ride. So there you have it, guys. After a long 2-year wait, we finally have the front end dry run assembled to the bike. Again, I'm so sorry for the long delay. Lost motivation on the project between moving and work, but we finally made it here, and I'm really looking forward to finishing out this build and showing the whole process for you guys. Well, guys, that wraps it up for the episode, and I'm really looking forward to getting back on this project, so stay tuned. And since I haven't been very active recently in the comments, if you had any questions come up in the meantime, just go ahead and comment them in, and I'll try and answer. Take care, and we'll see you on the next episode.